Hey guys, James here from Devoted Gaming, and this is a walkthrough for Ni No Kuni, Wrath of the White Witch. Hey guys, welcome back to the walkthrough. Today I'll be showing you guys the hidden treasures in the Tahiti Island area. Our first one's actually up here. Where is it? Here it is. A dryad spear. That's actually a pretty good weapon. But it's really boosts both your attack and magical attack. But the thing is, both my familiars that use it aren't really meant for attacking. But that's fine. I think I'll just give it to Boro. Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna step to the next treasure. Okay, so just a side note, there are monsters called Mohawks here, which sometimes drop, or you can steal, Ember Stones. And Ember Stones are needed for another task that we started. Am I lucky here? Let's see. Yes, got Ember Stone. I can complete my task about the alchemy stuff back at Castaway Cove. But that's gonna have to wait till after I'm done with the events here. But I might as well finish constructing the thing. I don't think we have a formula for it, it's gonna randomly mix and match it, I guess. So we need the weapon, which is the... where is it? Flint dagger? Just one. And we need the ember stone we just got from fighting the Mohawk guys. And with that, we got a candle cutter. So we just show that to that girl in Castaway Cove, and our task is complete. Anyway, back to treasure hunting. Now, I believe the next treasure should be... I can't walk over that, really? Can't walk over that either? Okay. Now, there aren't that many hidden treasures here because, you know, it's a small island after all. Well, compared to the other islands, it is kind of big. Now, I believe the next treasure should be... you know where that shiny respawn point is? It should be at this rock. Yep. We got a sore tooth ring. And it boosts your vitality and magical attack. I think I'll just give it to Oliver. Alright, so I resume the video at the next treasure. Alright, so the next treasure is actually near your shipwreck. It's by the beach. Just follow it and then reach the end. It should be here. Right? There it is. Got two sprockets. Alright, next treasure. So, our next treasure should be here on this tiny little peninsula kind of thing. And next treasure. Okay, so there are no more hidden treasures on the island, but there's a hidden area on this island. See that waterfall we're heading towards? There's actually a cave there. And in that cave, there were a couple of chests. Actually, not a couple, I think it's just two. So this isn't technically hidden treasures, but it is hidden. It's not going to tell you there's something here. And there are some crabs to talk to here, but you have to use your nature's tongue spell. But I don't think they say anything interesting or give you anything interesting. Anyway, let's just take our stuff. A fish burger. And to prove out, just use your tongue right now. And the thing is, in order to talk to each crab, you have to cast nature's tongue every single time. And there are a few crabs in here. Yep, we need it every time. I don't know why, I just cast it to talk to one. I guess they speak different languages. Okay, I'll just do one more. I think they give you some friendly advice, but that's about it. Anyway, and there's one more treasure here. And you need Swain to get it. It's behind this rock pillar. Ready? And we get Water Bomb Gem. I think that's all the treasures in this cave. And that's all the hidden treasures on the Tahiti Island. So, yeah. I think I will end the video here. And of course, I also completed that one task, the Young Alchemist, with the Ember Stone. I better remember to turn that in when I'm back at Castaway Cove. Anyway, so I'm going to end the video here. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.